Thank you. I see we're joined by Senator Barrasso from the great state of Wyoming.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Mr. Chairman, during the last Congress, both the House and the Senate failed to enact the Clean Water Restoration Act introduced by former Senator Russ Feingold and former Congressman James Oberstar. This was the bill that would grant the Environmental Protection Agency and the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers virtually unlimited regulatory control over all wet areas within a state. This included everything from groundwater to ditches to prairie potholes and to gutters. This bill trumped states' rights by preempting state and local governments from making local land and water use decisions. As you may recall, the measure was highly controversial. It was still strongly opposed by farmers, ranchers, small business owners, back certainly in my home state and in the home states of many members of this committee. The bill never passed either the House of Representatives or the Senate. You would think that that would be the end of it. But apparently, the Environmental Protection Agency and the U.S. Army Corps think differently. These agencies appear to be unilaterally asserting authority to enact the Clean Water Restoration Act without a vote from Congress. At the same time, they would be reversing a direct decision by the United States Supreme Court that limited the federal government's authority to regulate these waters. A recently leaked EPA document marked, quote, deliberative process, colon, confidential draft from the December 2010 states that the EPA and the Army Corps will identify the waters they believe should be under federal jurisdiction. The document also spells out how their unilateral decision to do this, quote, supersedes previously issued guidance on the scope of waters of the United States subject to the Clean Water Act programs, close quote. The leaked document goes further to say that the EPA and Army Corps expect that the number of waters found to be subject to the Clean Water Act jurisdiction will increase significantly. This draft guidance would grant the Environmental Protection Agency and the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers virtually unlimited regulatory control over all wet areas within a state. This guidance also trumps states' rights by preempting state and local governments from making local land and water use decisions. Enormous resources will be needed to expand the Clean Water Act federal regulatory program, which could lead to longer permitting delays. Increased delays in securing permits will impede a host of economic activities across all 50 states. Commercial and residential real estate development, agriculture, electric transmission, transportation, and mining will be affected, and thousands of jobs will be lost. Not surprisingly, I see the Army Corps increase funding in its budget for its regulatory program this past year. The justification of the funding request is to, quote, implement new field-level initiatives for Clean Water Act jurisdictional determination and rulemaking and inflation. The American people rejected the Clean Water Restoration Act in the last Congress. It was a bad idea then. It is still a bad idea now. It must be stopped, and Congress's authority must be restored. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I look forward to the testimony.
Thank you, Senator.